Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up question 51 to 54 of class 8 Aryabhatta paper 2018 section D. So let's look at this question. If a right circular cone with a slant height L and a right circular cylinder have the same radius R, same total surface area and height H and H dash respectively, then find the value of L minus R by L plus R. So let's first of all draw a cone and a cylinder. Now the radius of both of them are R. The height of the cylinder is H dash. Height of the cone is H and the slant height is L. Now the total surface area of cone is equal to pi r into r plus l, and total surface area of cylinder is 2 pi r into r plus h dash. Now since the surface area are given to be equal, this means pi r into r plus l is equal to 2 pi r into r plus h dash. So pi r cancels on both sides and we take this 2r on the left hand side. So this becomes L minus. So first is r plus L is equal to twice of r plus h dash. And then L minus r becomes 2h dash. Let's call this 1 and this 2. Now we know that for cone, the slant height L square is equal to r square plus h square. So we can say L square minus R square is equal to H square, and we can write this as L minus R into L plus R is equal to H square. Now if we put the value of L minus R from 2 into this third equation, we get 2 H dash into L plus R is equal to H square. So this gives us L plus R is equal to H square by 2 H dash. Now we have to find the value of L by L minus R by L plus R. So we divide 2 by 4. So we get L minus R divided by L plus R is equal to 2 H dash by H square by 2 H dash. So this is nothing but 4 H dash square by H square. So this is the answer to this question. Moving to the next question. In this figure, AE is perpendicular to BC, D is the midpoint of BC. If AB is equal to C, AE is equal to H, AD is equal to D, BC is equal to A, and AC is equal to B, find the value of ED in terms of A, B and D. So let's call this as X. And we know that D is the midpoint of BC, right? So this would mean BD is equal to DC and AE is given to be perpendicular to BC. These two things are given to us. So now from here we get B square, which is nothing but AC square, is equal to H square plus EC square, and EC square is nothing but A by 2 plus X whole square. Now we also know from in triangle AED, we know that H square is nothing but D square minus X square. So if we put this value of H square in here, we get B square is equal to D square minus X square plus A square by 4 plus X square plus AX. So this X square cancels with this. So we get 4AX is equal to 4B square minus 4d square minus a square. So this means X is equal to 4b square minus 4d square minus a square by 4a. So X is nothing but ED that we have to find out. So this is the answer to this question. Moving to the next question. A circle is inscribed in a square PQRS of side root 2 units each. So this is root 2. In the gap remaining at each corner, a square of maximum possible area is drawn. Find the radius of the circle that can be inscribed in each of the smaller squares. So we know that 2 times the diagonal of small square plus, so if we are just drawing this. So 2 times the diagonal of the small square plus the diameter of big circle is equal to the diagonal of big square. Right? So now let's call this diagonal of the small square to be small d. So we have 2d plus the diameter of the big circle is nothing but the side of the square, which is root 2, and this is equal to the diagonal of the big square is nothing but root 2 times this its side, which is root 2 into root 2. So we get 2d is equal to 2 minus root 2. So d is equal to 2 minus root 2 by 2. This is the diagonal of the small square. So now the side of the small square is 1 by root 2 times d, which will be equal to 2 minus root 2 by 2 root 2, and this we can also say 2 root 2 minus 1 by 2, right? And this is nothing but the diameter of small circle. The side of the small circle is the diameter of the small circle, so its radius will be equal to, we have to find the radius of the circle, so which will be half of root 2 minus 1 by 2. So this is root 2 minus 1 by 4. This much units. This is the answer to this question. Now moving to the last question of this session. In the figure, 2 identical circles are drawn of radius 12 cm each with centers C and C dash, with AB and BD being respective tangents at A and D. If BE is their common tangent and AB is perpendicular to BD, find the length of BD. So we know that AB is equal to BE is equal to BD. We know the theorem which says that the tangents on a circle from an external point are equal. So AB and BE are tangents to the circle with center C. And similarly, BE and ED are the tangents to the circle of with center C dash from the point B. So these are all equal. So now, if we draw this, we know that we can prove that triangle ACB is congruent to triangle ECB. This would imply, and similarly, the triangles EB C dash and DB C dash will also be congruent. So this will prove that angle ABC is equal to angle CBE, and that is equal to angle EBC dash, and that is equal to angle C dash BD, and all of them, because the total of all of these is 90, so this each of these will be 22.5 degree, and this would imply angle ACE is equal to 135 degree. Why? Because we know this is 90, this is 90. Tangents make an angle of 90 degree with its radius at that same point. So this would mean, and this angle we know, angle ABE, we know is 45 degree, 25.5 plus 22.5. So this gives us angle ACE as 135 degree. And similarly, angle DC dash E will also be 135 degree. Now, if we take the trapezium, if we join AD, we we get a trapezium ACC dash D, and this is an isosceles trapezium because AC is equal to C dash D and both of them are equal to the radius, which is 12 degree, and CC 12 centimeter, and CC dash is 24, right? So now angle CAD will be 45 degree. So this implies if we drop a perpendicular here and a perpendicular here, so this would imply that AP is nothing but 12 cos 45, or we can say 12 by root 2, which is 6 root 2 centimeter. Similarly, QD is also 6 root 2 centimeter. So AD becomes 6 root 2 plus 24 plus 6 root 2. This is equal to 24 plus 12 root 2 centimeter. This is what AD is. Now we have to find out BD. Now we know that AB whole square plus BD whole square is equal to AD whole square. We are just using the Pythagoras theorem here. And we know that AB and AD are equal. We've already mentioned this here. So this implies twice of BD square will be equal to AD square. So BD is nothing but 1 by root 2 times of AD, which is 24 plus 12 root 2 by root 2. Or we can say this is 12 plus 12 root 2 centimeter. And we can further simplify it and we can say 12 into root 2 plus 1. Centimeter. So this is the answer to this question. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.